Hello and welcome to Around the Clock. I'm your host, Yolanda Greaves. On today's show, we'll have the Select Board update for the meeting that happened on June 19th. We'll be having our Around the Town tour, and we'll also be going up to the State House to hear and see some great pictures and footage about the Unsung Heroine Awards that were presented to two Ashland residents, as well as other women across the state. We will be stopping in at the Corner Spot for movie night, as well as a few other locations. So stay with us as I bring you Around the Clock. Hello and welcome to the Select Board update for the meeting that happened on June 19th. I'm actually going to take you back a little bit to the meeting that happened on June 5th. That was the first Select Board meeting after the new election. Welcome to Brandy Kinsman and congratulations to Joe Mignani on his re-election. At the June 5th meeting, two important items. There was a reorganization done. Steve Mitchell is now the chair, I am the vice chair, and Joe Mignani is now the clerk. The other debate and discussion that happened that's critical for that evening was we have voted to change the name. We are now called the Select Board versus the Ashland Board of Selectmen. Moving forward, all information going out will be as Select Board. We've also directed the town manager to draft information and draft an article for the fall special town meeting. And then it has been recommended to the next Charter Review Committee that they also do all gender neutral titles and names, including Select Board moving forward. It will take a little while for that all to happen, but we are officially known as the Select Board. I'm going to now go into the update for the meeting that happened on June 19th. It was actually a somewhat short and quick meeting. We had a couple of updates. The first was from the Upper Charles Trail Committee. They came in and let us know where they're at. They've applied for a grant for the Trolley Brook Trail portion, which is off the MBTA Access Road. They're also looking for a little more support from our town planner and for some GIS information, because to be able to really get a full grant to do more work, we need to have some engineering done. From there, we went into an update from our Economic Development Director, Beth Reynolds, and she reviewed the rules and regulations for the new Economic Development Incentive Program. This program was passed and approved at town meeting by the voters. We now have approved the regulations that will be going into effect to be able to run this. And from what we heard from Beth Reynolds, there are already a number of companies that are coming into Ashland who are in Ashland who are looking to take advantage of this program. If you want more details, you can certainly watch the full meeting and see the full presentation that Beth did on this information, as well as the information will be up on the website. From there, we got updates on our five major projects, our sort of strategic priority projects, the Rail Transit District. So Tom Powers from UGC, they are the developers that are looking to put a 62 and over development on Parcel 2, which is as you're going up the MBTA Access Road on your left-hand side between the middle school and the Cirrus Apartments. They're going to be doing a balloon test. They've already done a walkthrough. Some of the plans there, we're going to be going before the planning board on the 27th of June. So if you'd like to see those plans, they'll be available through the planning board site after the 27th. We got an update on the public safety building. A big thank you to Joe Mignani for continuing to work with the Faffords. They have donated another portion of the land. So we got about 4 acres, which was accepted at the May town meeting, as well as the funding to do the engineering for the public safety building. They have now donated another 4 or 5 acres, which is in back of the public safety building. And this will allow us to look at the Upper Charles Trail, possibly going through there as a little bit more land for the public safety building. So thank you to Joe for working on that. And the public safety building meetings are happening. If you're interested, you can go sit in on them. We then had an update on the downtown improvements. You're going to start seeing work probably in the beginning of July on the water pipes in downtown. And then from the water pipes, we'll also start working on streetscapes, and then we'll work on undergrounding the utilities. It's a process that will be happening. You'll see the water work starting on Main Street over by Water Street, and then it'll also be happening on Summer Street from Cherry Street. So there'll be a lot of construction in downtown this summer, but all moving forward to some great redevelopment for the downtown area. We then had a quick update on the townwide strategic plan. It's been on hold for a little bit, but Michael Herbert, who is running it, our town manager, is going to be doing a little bit more work on that. They're doing some drafts, and it has been recommended that he try to tie it into the Metro Common 2050, which is our regional planning for the 101 cities and towns plan that is also out. We then had an update on the Warren District, and this also includes the Valentine property. And we were notified that on Monday, July 22nd, there will be a discussion at the community center starting at 7 p.m. regarding ideas and what people would like to see happening at the Valentine Estate. So that'll be posted more via social media, as well as we'll send that out through the town emails. But just put it on your calendar if you're watching now, July 22nd at 7 p.m., a discussion at the community center regarding the Valentine property and what people want to see there. We then approved our consent agenda. We have some new hires, both in the police and fire department, and in our meeting in July, we'll be inviting all the new hires from the beginning of the year to come and join us at the select board meeting. We approved a memorandum of agreement, so basically the union contract for our Ashland Police Department. That goes back to July 1 of 2018, and it goes through June 30th of 2021. We had a brief update on the Eversource process. Our briefings have been filed, and if you're interested, you can go to EFSB, Energy Siting Board, docket number 18-2, and the Eversource company will be going before CONCOM on June 24th. We signed some notes for borrowing, for some of the borrowing that was approved at town meeting in May. We had an update on the excise bill issue that happened and came before us in our June meeting. Also, the municipal aggregation program, which is your electricity rates. Eversource is dropping their rate for 6 months. Ours is going to be a little bit higher, but remember, our aggregate program is helping us fund the sustainability coordinator. That job description is almost finalized, and that posting should be going up within the next week or two at all the normal places that we post jobs in Ashland. And then the other last news was there was an exercise grant that we got for some new exercise equipment that will be going in behind the community center. When it goes in, we'll take you there and show it to you and even show you how to use some of it. That's very exciting. It's through our insurance company and through some of the great work our public service and health and wellness department and rec department is doing through our community center. And that wrapped up the select board meeting for June 19th, 2019. Hello and welcome back to Around the Clock. It's time for our Around the Town tour. Things have been very busy since the beginning of June, so we have a fair amount of things to share with you. We're going to take them a little bit out of order. We're going to talk to you first about an event that happened on Saturday, June 22nd. Through the past number of years, we've shared the story with you of Jake Silver, a young Ashland resident who lost his fight with osteosarcoma, a form of cancer, back a couple of months ago. Well, his family, his mom and his sister, and many members of our community have joined together to start fundraising for Jake's team. Jake's team is doing a couple of things. They are awarding money for cancer research for childhood cancer. They are also supporting the Silver's Sibling Foundation. And this is a foundation to support those children whose siblings are fighting cancer and to help those families deal with it as well. And then another great cause is Kim's Cases. This is an opportunity, it's a company, it's an organization that is taking and giving satin pillowcases to children who are fighting cancer, and that happens from every pillowcase they sell. So let's go take a look and maybe chat with some people about the 5K that happened on June 22nd.
for coming and making Jake's Team Kickoff Walk and Dedication such a great success. Jake's Team Kickoff Walk has raised over $35,000, which will help it get it up and running. Yeah. A large chunk of this will go to the Dana-Farber Jimmy Clinic for Childhood Cancer Research. We're happy and proud to report that in the last 3 years, we have raised over $120,000 for research in Jake's name. Wow. With that, I'd like to thank some of our generous sponsors: Barstool Sports, 126 Self Storage in Ashland, Ashland Ice, Calculator Soup, .com, Elizabeth Blake Orthodontics, Solar Flare Energy Inc., The Grunt Family, AAF CPA, Ashland Lumber Company, Ashland Pet Concierge, Auburn Industrial Development Corporation, The Bagel Table, Dairy Queen, Hastings Consulting Inc., Jack's Abbey, Metro West Sports Center, Stone's Public House, The Reisner Family, Post Road Pediatrics, Wine Empire, and Mara Flooring and Design. And for a full list of all our generous sponsors, please visit our website. We came up with the idea with the foundation in the ICU in Atlanta with Jake. He and Hallie were discussing what he would want his legacy to be, and he made us promise to still raise money for osteosarcoma after he was gone. We talked about doing something for siblings because he knew that cancer didn't only affect him, but it affected our entire family, especially Hallie. So Hallie and I came up with Jake's Team, which raises money for cancer research, and through Silver Siblings and Kim's Cases, we are able to help the families and children fighting cancer.
When Jake was sick, he would get gift cards, gifts, tickets, meet people, and everyone would come by to see him. I knew exactly why, and I was fine with it, but I also had feelings of being forgotten, invisible, or like I wasn't in the room. These feelings were hard to come to terms with. I knew he was getting all the attention because he was sick, but I still had these feelings that I couldn't shake. But recently, I have learned these feelings were normal and many other siblings have them. That's why Jake and I came up with Silver Siblings. He could understand what I was going through and felt like we should help in some way. The way this works is people can fill out a form on our website that refers a sibling of a child with cancer and what their likes and interests are, and we will send them a gift basket and a letter accordingly. Eventually, we would like it to become something like a big brother, big sister type of organization, but baby steps.
The third part of Jake's Team is Kim's Cases. Kim's Cases is in memory of Kim Desiata, and this is her daughter, Erica. Back in 2016, when Jake was first diagnosed, Kim was fighting her own battle with cancer. Kim's advice to us was to buy Jake a satin pillowcase, because once he starts losing his hair and when it starts growing back, cotton pillowcase will irritate his head, whereas a satin one will not. Jake had a white satin pillowcase that he went everywhere with him for the next 3 years. Kim's Cases will donate one satin pillowcase to a child fighting cancer for every pillowcase that is sold through Team Jake. Through Thanks. Jake's team. Sorry.
Thanks, Erica.
Thank you, Erica.
Thank you, Erica.
As many of you know, Jake wasn't really a walker. He liked us to do the Jimmy Fun Walk, and he wants us to continue with it. So we are. You can sign up to be a part of our team called Silver Strong, and I am the captain. But walking in general wasn't his thing, and so we don't think it should be Jake's team thing either. Instead, for now on, our fundraisers will be two things that Jake loved. In the fall and September this year, we'll be holding a Jake's Team Cornhole Tournament, and in the springtime, we will be having a barbecue cook-off, so be sure to watch for those. We hope these events can bring communities and people together, which is the goal of Jake's Team. We are hoping that groups will get together to raise money for Jake's Team. Examples would be a team donating the proceeds of admission tickets for one of their games, or a club doing a 50-50 raffle at one of their events. Teams can have car washes, etc. There is even a nonprofit who raises money for children's charities who will be holding a bake sale for Jake's Team today from 9 to 1 p.m. in the Needham Bank parking lot in Ashland. The ideas can be creative as the team wants or something that another team has already done, as long as people come together for a good cause like we did today.
Which brings us to the second part of the day, the dedication of the bench. Here's a little backstory. So Jake was concerned that because he was being cremated, there wasn't going to be a place for people to visit him. So Tony and I told him that we would buy a bench at the high school so people could come to his favorite place, which was the football field, and visit him. And he loved the idea. As we were looking into things, it came up that the bench should also be for PJ Ferrier, Jake's friend and another football player who passed away from osteosarcoma in December. While I was searching benches, I thought maybe it would be nice to have two Adirondack chairs instead. But Jake, in typical Jake fashion, said no. He said he'd really be upset if everybody sat in PJ's chair and not mine. So we have a bench. There we go. The inscription reads, dedicated to two young men who fought just as hard off the field as they did on. Jake Silver, number 63, class of 2008, and PJ Ferrier, 2018, and PJ Ferrier, number 5, class of 2014. We want to thank all of you who have made our family vision a reality. It's hard to lose a child and a brother, and we are doing Jake's team because our family doesn't want any other child or family to go through what we went through, and we want to continue the legacy that Jake started. So thank you all for coming. Feel free to sit and have a little chat with Jake. The other thing is there's been a hawk flying around, and one of the things that Jake had said to us, how we would know that he was around, is he told us that he would either come back as a hawk or an eagle to let us know that he was okay. And there was a hawk earlier today flying over registration. So thank you all.
So part of the dedication was a bench that went up on the football field in Jake's honor because that was his favorite place. Thank you to our crew for getting out to the Jake's 5K and good luck. And if you want to donate to Jake's team, you can go to their website and donate even if you didn't get the opportunity to run and help support the great causes that Jake's team is supporting.
3, 2.
We're going to continue our around the town tour. We're going to go back a little bit now to June 9th. It was a Sunday morning, a beautiful Sunday morning, and we were at the Hopkinton Outdoor YMCA for the Metro West K9 5K. This was partly sponsored by the Massachusetts Veterinary Medical Association for their MVMA charities. One of them was Vests for Dogs. The funds are also needed for strayed animals and provides emergency and disaster preparedness and response education for communities across Massachusetts. There was a great turnout, lots of fun dogs, and we got to speak to a few people. Todd Carter was there with his camera and his microphone. Let's take a look and a listen.
We're with, we're Girl Scouts, and we're working on our bronze award. And we're working with
Buddy Dog.
And we're promoting Adopt-A-Shop.
Hi, we're with Best Friends Pet Hotel. This is a great day to be out here. Getting everybody's attention with all these dogs out here is fantastic opportunity for everybody to get outside with a dog, get some exercise. Great day out here with the sunshine.
Thank you very much.
I'm the owner of Canine Cage Training Academy. We're here to help out as many dogs as we can and help out the MVMA charities.
Welcome to BASC. BASC is Balance and Service Canines. They are a not-for-profit volunteer organization that raises service dogs for first responders and veterans.
Hi, I'm Shelby with Canine Company. We're here at the 5K Canine event today. I'm super excited to be here. Canine Company does at-home pet containment and training as well as our mobile spa. I'm really excited to be here at this event because it's so important to keep dogs active and healthy, and it looks like they're building a great relationship with their owners at this point.
Hi, my name's Anite. I'm with the Mass Animal Fund. We're part of the Department of Agricultural Resources, and we provide spay and neuter vouchers for low-income residents. That's it.
here sponsoring the Ashland Dog Park, which is getting close to having a site. We think we may be near the Dunkin' Donuts and the Rancid Trail District, certainly one of the possibilities. And we're going to get a grant to cover most of the cost, but we're doing some fundraising to cover the part that's not going to be covered by the grant. There'll be a dog park for the big dogs and another one for the smaller dogs and the older dogs. So it'll be a great place for Ashland Doggies.
Thank you, Todd, for getting out there and seeing all those dog owners and dog supporters, and of course, the dogs themselves. We're going to continue our around the town tour. We're going to head down to the Corner Spot, one of the most popular places in Ashland these days. There's always some food or music or great shops popping up in the shed at the Corner Spot. But this time we're going to talk about the summer movie night that happened on June 14th. If it's something weird and it don't look good, who you gonna call? These are actually sponsored by WACA-TV, those of us here at Ashland Cable. The first summer movie night was The Ghostbusters. Popcorn and candy are available for purchase, as well as Street Food RX. Eastleigh Farm Ice Cream Truck and Beer and Wine from Wine Empire were there on June 14th. There are two more definite dates and a potential third date coming up, and they are on July 26th and then on August 23rd, and you can check out the website to find out what those movies are. Well, it sounds like everyone had a great time. It was a little windy, but it seemed to be a perfect night for a movie, and we're hoping the same on July 26th and August 23rd. We hope to see you at both of those coming up in the summer. From the Corner Spot, we're going to go off to Milford, and our Ashland High School boys played Medway for the playoff finals at Pheno Field in Milford. Our Ashland High School boys had a great baseball season. They went all the way to these finals. Unfortunately, they did lose 1-0. Milford beat them by one. But congratulations to all our baseball players, and we'll be giving you some updates later on in the summer of the post. The Legion post games, because many of our baseball players went right from playing those finals to playing some more baseball this summer. Well, from there, from Milford, we're going to come back to Ashland. And we're going to go to the farmer's market. It's already been 3 weeks of the farmer's market. Unfortunately, we weren't able to get to the first weeks, but we were able to visit Strawberry Festival. It's a great time. All the vendors have things and food and items that are related to strawberries. And as always, it was some nice weather and a great turnout at the market. If you are interested in learning how to film and be part of the WACA crew, to get some of that great B-roll, to get out and see some of these events that are going on and help us film them, make sure you reach out to us here at WACA-TV. Also, if you're interested in learning how to send out those government meetings, we are looking for some people there. So again, if you're interested, reach out to us here at WACA-TV. We are willing to train. All you need to be is interested and willing to learn. Well, that wraps up our Around the Town tour. If you have an event you'd like to share, please make sure you reach out to us. And we'll be back later in the summer with more Around the Clock and Around the Town. And now we'd like to share with you an event that happened on June 18th up at the Massachusetts State House. This was the 16th annual Unsung Heroines of Massachusetts Award Ceremony. It was sponsored by the Massachusetts Commission on the Status of Women. The Massachusetts Commission on the Status of Women was established back in 1998 as a way to honor and work and understand the status of women in Massachusetts and help forward that status and help forward women in Massachusetts. Ashland was very honored to have two of their own supported and honored and represented at this heroine, Unsung Heroine Award. The first was Ellie Torelli. She has been in Ashland for many, many years, and she was nominated by Rep. Jack Lewis.
Rising from Freeze. Eleanor Torelli. Eleanor, in addition to managing a company and working as a bus driver for over 30 years, clearly a very patient woman, Ellie is a 40-year Lions Club member, serving as the Greater Ashland Lions President and an environmental chair for the 33K District Lions Clubs. She's organized scholarships, the donation of a park bench to the Ashland Veterans Memorial, and the revival of seedlings for Arbor Day at the Ashland Mindless School, and has received 2 awards from the Lions Club International Foundation.
We want to congratulate Ellie Torelli on her nomination and on her Unsung Heroine Award. It was unfortunate that she was not able to be there. The second woman who was representing Ashland as an unsung heroine is Beth Reynolds. She is our Economic Development Director. She's been in the position since 2016, and she was nominated by State Senator Karen Spilka, our Senate President.
I'd like to also recognize the unsung heroines, my nominee, Beth Reynolds, who I've known for a long time in Ashland, in the town that I live in, who serves as the Economic Development Director for the town of Ashland. And I highlight Beth, and I hope I'm not embarrassing you, Beth, but all the work that you do in each one of your fields, you go about it, you work hard, and you just do it. You don't ask for pats on the back, you don't ask for congratulations, but you make such an incredible, positive difference in the community and that you live in the surrounding communities. That's why this event is so terrific. And Beth is similar, maybe doing different specific tasks and duties, but just like each and every one of you here, Beth has advanced economic growth through advocacy, collaboration, and education. And providing and finding, which sometimes is not always easy, resources for Ashland businesses and stakeholders. She's been an outstanding voice for the business community in Ashland and for the residents of Ashland, has really made some unique advances in Ashland to help us build our community in our town. So it was great to be able to nominate her for the well-deserved Unsung Heroine Award. And I hear that from all the other legislators, from all the other work, and I have to say, in talking to the other legislators, the one thing that's always so nice for me, when they talk about whoever it is that they have nominated, they can't help but smile. So it's just a really nice event, and it's a really nice thing.
We had the honor of being able to congratulate Beth Reynolds in person at our last Board of Selectmen meeting as she came and presented on one of the great programs that she has created here in Ashland for as our Economic Development Director. Congratulations both to Ellie and to Beth, and thank you to our State Representative Jack Lewis and Senate President and our Senator Karen Spilka for nominating these two women for this very, very prestigious award. Well, thanks for watching this episode of Around the Clock. As your host, Yolanda Greaves, I enjoy bringing you the news and events that are going on here in Ashland as well as in the Metro West region. If you ever have a story that you'd like to share with us, please make sure you reach out to us at WACA-TV or Around the Clock via Facebook. We look forward to sharing more news about Ashland with you.